In Cataclysm 18, we introduced the Chaos Circuit, and more specifically, we looked at the formation of Leon Shua's Memristor paddles around Asheville, North Carolina. These paddles are what tell us that there was both a magnetic field producing the Appalachian Mountains and an electric charge being stored and managed in a chaos circuit during the cataclysm. This coronal loop formation across eastern North America caused a locomotive inductance, a spinning in the middle of what we now call the state of Michigan, and formed the Great Lakes. Inductance moves things is our takeaway. Survivors in present-day South America looked north and east and saw a plumed serpent. Survivors from central North America looked directly east and saw a giant thunderbird with coronal loop wings. And individuals who survived from more or less directly under those coronal loops looked up and they saw a snake eating a charge. And they built an effigy to it with a celestial alignment marking the day. Follow me for just a brief moment down these coronal loops as we look more closely at the chaos circuits that they created in eastern North America. Using the simple concepts of inductance and resistance, we can very quickly and very simply understand the formation event of the Gulf of Mexico and the Mississippi River. By understanding how this region of the planet was sculpted, we can then easily unwind what really caused one of the worst man-made disasters in world history, the Deepwater Horizon spill. I know that Fred's been chomping at the bit to talk a little bit about the effects of the cataclysm on weather today, and in this video, we'll answer so many questions, it might just leave you wondering why you haven't hit that like and subscribe button. Welcome to Cataclysm 18.2, the Gulf of Mexico and Mississippi River story, a Deepwater Horizon disaster in the making.
April 20th, 2010, the Deepwater Horizon drilling rig exploded in the Gulf of Mexico, killing 11 and injuring 17, leaving a man-made ecological disaster unrivaled on the planet. To understand what actually caused the event, we're going to need to answer two questions. One, why was the rig here? What is it about this spot and others like it that make it a good spot to drill? And two, what conditions may have existed to cause the explosion, which are yet unaccounted for if looked at from a cataclysm perspective? When properly oriented, the nature of the oil that they were drilling and the reason we should stop drilling it will become self-evident. In an electric circuit, an inductor is a curled wire that opposes sudden changes in current by choking the excess charge into a magnetic field that expands around the coil like a balloon. The inductor does this by a function called inductance, which is to say it stores the energy in a locomotive magnetic field. It spins. If I put a paperclip next to an inductor, as the magnetic field swells, eventually the magnetism is big enough that the paperclip is attracted to the magnet. This electromagnetic attraction is the same basic principle that formed the Gulf of Mexico. A massive magnetic field of inductance swelled, and the discharge formed the Gulf of Mexico. The video overlaid here is of an anode discharge in a liquid state. The pattern of the discharge carries significant characteristics matching not only the basin shape, but the central bulb must have also left a current flow pattern that was clockwise in the middle. As with the anode discharge, there were actually several points where eddies formed, leaving their own signature electrical field in the planet. All of these eddies represent an anode orientation, that is, electrons of the global circuit generally flowed outward from this zone, just as they did in the cataclysm. The surface currents of the Gulf, however, tell us of a massive electric discharge that formed the Mississippi. Just above the inductor is the resistor. Resistors of this sort are designed to dissipate charge, usually as heat, but in our case, it also did it by releasing a focalized lightning cathode discharge. The arc of lightning began by striking directly in front of the resistor in the ground, and then it began extracting electrons in a lightning discharge from the surface, like the wetted surface of wood used in Lichtenberg art creation. The discharge moved along the wet surface of the earth, moving north to complete the circuit. When the discharge had finished forming the Mississippi River some 2,340 miles long, it also left a hole right in front of the resistor that was at least 5 miles deep, and it's at least 5 miles because we know that's how deep the horizon was drilling when the accident occurred. Let's go back to the first question. Why was the rig here? What is it about this spot and others like it that makes it a good spot to drill down some 5 miles? At the time of the cataclysm, North America had a shallow ocean and lush green forests of giant trees. But after the cataclysm, the ocean and organic debris flowed down the newly formed Mississippi and drained directly into the newly formed hole left in front of the resistor, which again was at least 5 miles deep. It brought with it billions of tons of organic matter where it sat and liquefied over the next 12,000 years or so. Our oil is a remnant of the cataclysm, all of it. One fateful day, in their effort to extract that liquefied organic matter, their metal pipe got too close to the Earth's telluric current, and like a doorknob shocking you, the Earth sent a discharge up the drill, setting off an explosion and leaving one of the world's worst man-made disasters in history. The only reason they were drilling 5 miles down, and the only reason the hole existed in the first place, is that electrons flowed out of that hole and left the bias of the current in the Earth's crust. The inductor and the resistor of the chaos circuit still affect the weather today, causing nor'easters and any hurricane that comes into the area to increase in strength. In southern Florida, the anode end of the inductor left a giant round depression in the Florida Keys, which gives us an adequate amount of information to calculate the maximum size of the inductive field. Electrons flowed in this direction here. And if you're looking for the smoking gun to this thesis, here's the track of all Category 5 storms ever recorded. 4 of them go directly over the zone, and 1 right by. It is still a hotspot for the flow of electrons, which is exactly what superstorms need. The cataclysm formed virtually every surface feature of the Earth that we see today in some way. With every new discovery, we add another element to the incredible picture of Earth's real past, and more importantly, how it affects our world today. Like, share, subscribe. Don't forget to leave me your thoughts in the comments down below. Peace.